If you make your web application into a SAAS, you need your customers to log in. And this is to preserve personal information, make it possible to give a personalized experience, and of course, to monetize on the value that your web app is providing. But doing this sounds both dangerous and complicated. Not at all. Because FASTHTML have prepared some workflows for us. It's just to hook up your code to a framework client and then go. Let's go through some basic codes that works and then extend it into a bigger SaaS that uses roles as well. Let's get a feeling for how this works and looks. So, what authorization providers are supported by FASTHTML today? Today, we can choose from Google, GitHub, Hugging Face, and Discord. And of course, FASTHTML is open to contributions of newer or other authorization flows. So which of these you should choose, it depends a lot about what customers are you expecting to have from your SaaS. But in this case, we don't really have a use case, so I just take the biggest one. In this video, let's just go with Google. To use Google OAuth 2, we need a client ID and a client secret from Google. And to do this, we need to go to the Google Cloud Dashboard, create a new project for this reason. And in this project, we need to enable the OAuth API. We need to provide data to a login page and then generate the API keys. For detailed description about this Google flow, I refer to someone more experienced in it than I am. But Google has a lot of resources, and I'm sure there is a YouTube video for it as well. The main point is that we have our keys from Google. And in this case, I will store them in a .environment file and read them in when we need them. This is perhaps not the production way of doing it, but let's get this working. So, what does this minimal code look like? Up here, we have some imports that we're taking from FASTHTML OS and SIS. And then we have a piece of code that's reading in the client ID and the client secret from this .environment file. I know there are library files to do this, but let's get this working. And then we define our client. In this case, it is a Google App client, and we're using our client ID and our client secret. Then we set up an auth class, which is a subclass from OAuth. This one has a function called getAuth, and we will get back to them later in the flow. Then we have definition of the app itself and a definition of an OAuth, which uses this class auth and puts in the application and the Google App client. When it does this, it defines what is in FASTHTML called beforeware. Something that we can't see in this here, but it is defined and it's running before you enter any URL. So if you're not logged in, you will be thrown away to the login page. Then we define the login page. Here it's really minimal. We're just stating that you are not logged in, and here is the link to log in. And what should happen when someone presses this login link is simply that the Google App client will send you off to Google's authorization login page, where you need to select an account and approve everything. And then we have the root page. And when we get here, we are logged in into the application. Of course, we are showing a way to log out from the application. So, the flow. The before where enter all our accesses to the login page. Then we can press the login button. This one sends us off to Google. And when we approved everything that Google require of us, we will be sent back to this getAuth function. And here we have a chance to look at what comes to us and see if we approve it or not. And in this case, we have it in this side. We just approve everything that is a verified email from Google. So not a very good login. Everyone with a Google account can log into this page. But this is the check, and we will work on this one more later. And if this one is true, we will return a redirect response to the root page of the application with a status code redirect. And that ends us up in the logged in page. So that's the basics. Let's look at how it looks. And here we are at the login page. After that, we can click the login. And then we are logged in to the application, and everything is happy, I hope. And we can log out again. That basic setup lacks a bit. For the first, we want a database of approved users, not allowing everyone with a Google account to log in. Secondly, we want to be able to have roles for different users, such as administrators or gold members. So what do we need to change to do that? Looking into the extended code, we have exactly the same imports and the reading of the client ID and client secret. And then here we have a database of approved users. In this case, I just implemented as a list of dictionaries, and each dictionary contains some user data. Note it here that we have an admin of type Boolean, which gives me the role of admin in this app. And then moving down, we have getUserById. This is a function that searches the database for a certain user ID. And then we have the auth class with the getAuth function. This time around, we do a search based on info sub. And this is the ID that I'm using into my database for my users. And then we can also look at what we do to accept a user into our application. It's this line. First, it needs to be a verified email by Google, and it also needs to be a user that we have in our database. And if that's true, then we redirect to the root of the web application. Something that is in quotes here is if the email is verified by Google, but it doesn't exist in the database, then we should do some type of user creation workflow. But more on that in next video. Moving down, we create our client in the same way as we did before. We do our application the same way. The OAuth is the same. And then we have the login page. And this time I styled it a bit with a few cards. But it's basically the same information. It looks like a landing page trying to sell something to you with a pain and an offer to buy. But then we have the same thing we had before, the you are not login and a link that you can log in with. After that, we have the new web page. And this one now gets the auth. And this time, we read some variables from the authorization database dictionary. Let's call it the user dictionary that contains this user data. And we're reading them out. Here, we have a top card, welcome card, which also print out my given name on the web page. And then we have an admin slot, which is only shown if I have the admin role is set to true. And then we have the normal, you are logged in, and here's a link if you want to log out. And in this case, I just made a simple an if on the boolean admin add to if we should insert the admin card or not. And then the web page is presented. Okay, so what does this look like? Here we have the landing page that everyone gets to see, the pain, the offer, and we're not logged in, so let's click it. We end up in Google. I choose my email at Google and said everything is hunky-dory for that one. And then we are logged into this one. And on the welcome page, my name is listed. And as it's shown here, I am admin. And we can, of course, log out again. And this is what it looks like. Getting keys from a provider, integrating that provider's client into our FASTHTML code, and controlling access via the getAuth function. That is the simple three-step workflow to preserve your customers' private data, enabling their personalization of their UX, and monetization of the value that your application is providing. In the next video in this series, I will go into billing as well as account creation. If there is anything else that you missed about my series on FASTHTML, I will put a link to the playlist up here. So click one of them and I will see you there in just a second.